Hi, I'm Ross, designer of the Port Espresso Specialty Coffee System, which consists of the Rosser Hand Espresso and the Roscoe Hand Grinder. I'm just going to run you through the basic operation of the system. First, you want to measure out your coffee beans. I find a 50ml shot glass seems to work pretty good. And you want to put them into the grinder, like so. Pop the cap back on. The grind size has already been set, which I'll describe in another video. So you want to get the filter head, screw it into the Roscoe, which is pretty cool. Actually grinds directly into the basket, which is nice and neat. Single shot loading, so you only grind what you need. Takes roughly 40 seconds to do enough for a double shot, which is, well, I use about 21, 22 grams. It's fairly easy to operate the grinder. Just shake the last bit through. Remove the bottom. Notice that's pretty well clean. You can see in the screen there. And that's how it comes out of the grinder. It's in a pre-tamped condition. Move my black shirt. It's in a pre-tamped condition from the way that the cutter moves. So all you need to do then is just finish off the tamping. Cool. Right, then you grab the Rosser, the spindle retracted. Boil your kettle. Need to preheat the device. Pretty simple procedure and surprisingly accurate. This kettle, fill it up. I wait about 20 seconds. For anyone that's particularly fussy, you can use a thermometer to gauge heat. But if you put your little finger underneath on the brass bit, you can feel the heat as it comes through, and you can gauge the temperature. And with after a couple of goes, you'll soon figure out how hot it needs to be. That's pretty good. So about 5 seconds, the second lot, and fill up to about a centimetre below the top of the cylinder bore. And fit the head. And grab yourself a cup. And just turn it over, and just nice, smooth, steady turning. The key here is nice and smooth, continuous. Takes roughly about 30 seconds to build the pressure up before it gets to flow, which I'll describe in later videos, but that's actually very desirable. And the pressure builds up nice and slow. You find the stream is very steady. You find that the natural profile, I'll just sort of start to taper off the pressure a little bit now. That's all good. And steam up a bit of milk if you have that. There's plenty of milk frothing devices on the market, so I don't think I need to make one of them. Most shops have them. It's all pretty good. practice my lahai art, which I'm not very good at. But anyway, that's a pretty good coffee. About as good as it gets.